What's going on, guys? It is Carly here bringing you another weekly dose of horror. And I actually watched this one in preparation for last weekend, but I got really sick over the weekend, unfortunately, and just wasn't up for making a video at all. So, you know, this was supposed to be last week, but now we're doing it this week. So it does not matter. I've missed weeks before, but you know, what can you do? So today I'm going to be talking about Confessions of a Serial Killer from the year 1985, and this movie is essentially based off of Henry Lee Lucas, a you know, well-known serial killer back in that time period. But they do change his name in the movie as well as some of the other characters, and his name in the film is actually Daniel Ray Hawkins, which on a podcast I was calling him like David Smith or something completely off. But anyway, so the way the story is told is you basically have this Daniel character has been caught by the police, and he's in sort of, you know, the interrogation room, and he is essentially telling of all the murders he had committed, essentially confessing them. And while he's telling them, you're getting flashbacks to the scenes where he actually killed these women and, you know, brutalized them. So it's told that way, where it's kind of like a back and forth of him telling a story, and then you're getting a flashback, and then it kind of all leads up to this big ending where you see how he eventually did get caught. So yeah, this movie is actually really solid. Definitely an overlooked one. Of course, Henry Portrait of a Serial Killer came out in 86, but that one's definitely higher budgets and a little bit better in quality. But this one honestly is a good companion piece for that, because I feel like it's got very similar vibes and just acting and the overall way it's shot, very similar to what you get with that Henry movie. So I feel like anyone who has seen that would enjoy this one as well. You know, not very enjoyable, I guess I would say, or fun or anything like that, because it is a very dark and eerie, depressing type of film, just very downbeat, and has a lot of good brutal moments to it that are just very gritty and have that sort of realistic vibe to them. The way it's shot just kind of reminds you of TCM or something like that. It is VHS quality, because this is unfortunately a bootleg that I bought at a convention last year, just, you know, to watch, because I was trying to watch 85 movies. So not the best quality out there, of course, but it's one of those ones that I would love to see on better quality, because I feel like it would even enhance my viewing even more. But I think the performances, especially by you know, the guy playing Daniel or Henry or whatever you want to call him, are really well done, very realistic and just very eerie. You know, the thing with this guy is he was very just sort of proud in a way of what he was doing. For him, killing was made out to be sort of his hobby. He really didn't have any motives or anything. It's just he was very sick in the head and enjoyed killing people for fun, pretty much, and didn't really feel anything for it. And this guy really portrays that nature really well. He's just super just like, you know, I killed somebody. It's sort of, you know, like, oh, I fell and scraped my knee or something. You know, just the way he talks about stuff is just so not caring or anything like that. He doesn't really seem to realize what he has done or how horrible it is, and he portrays it really well. Just certain things he says and does, it's like he's carrying on life as a normal person would, and it's just very unsettling. The music that plays throughout, the score, is also super eerie to kind of go along with what's happening in the movie, and it pretty much plays throughout the entire thing. It reminds you more of like a crime TV show or something like that in that respect. So like that as well. Like I said, just very brutal in times, and solid film. I recommend it for people who like their serial killer based movies, and you know, especially if you like Henry, I do think you would enjoy this one as well, even though it is a little bit lower quality. Not super low budget though. I mean, it, you know, it feels not cheap or anything like that, if that makes any sense. So I give this movie an 8 out of 10. Again, definitely recommend it if you're into these types of films. So 8 out of 10 for Confessions of a Serial Killer. Thank you guys once again for joining me for this review. And as always, I'll see you next week.